A total eclipse of the sun, the most awesome of heavenly dramas.
People have been drawn together by the mystical power of eclipses for centuries.
Once an omen of evil and disaster, now a unique chance to learn more about our universe.
There's this funny coincidence where the size of the moon is about a 400th the diameter of the sun, and the distance to the moon is about a 400th of the distance to the sun. So because of that symmetry between those numbers, it's totally arbitrary. The moon can completely block the light from the sun.
So actually, solar eclipses are not as rare as you might think, but most of them actually happen over water because 70% of the Earth, of course, is covered in water and oceans. But here in the US, on the 8th of April, we are in this great position that the United States is in the path of the total solar eclipse. The next chance in the US is going to be in 2044. So if you don't have plans yet, 8th of April is a good time to see a gorgeous cosmic phenomenon. Here in Ithaca, what we'll see is the moon going partially in front of the sun, so it still will be light. It will be great to see, but make sure to have the right eyewear because you can hurt your eyes if you just look at it. Sunglasses are not enough.
If I put them on now, I can't see anything, but if you put them on and look at the sun, then you can really look right at it while these are on during the partial eclipse and see how much it's progressed. But if you don't have anything with you, a great approach is, one is just to go look for natural pinholes. And a beautiful way that this can occur, if there's enough leaves on the trees around here in April, but it's just looking for spots where you might get speckle patterns of sunlight on the ground. And you can actually see these arcs of the sun in the shadows on the ground, which is a beautiful sight. Now you can also just take a piece of cardboard and punch a little hole in it and use that to project the partial eclipse onto the ground like a pinhole camera. And as long as the shadow's dark enough, you'll be able to see how much of the sun is covered at that time.
Solar eclipses can be from about 10 seconds to about 7 minutes. And we got a great one with 4 minutes coming up on the 8th of April. And if you were to eat your greens in 2186, there'll be the 7 minute one you could see from Venezuela. But I think I'll take the 4 minute one we have right now. I'm so looking forward to see the next one because it gives you a reappreciation of our beautiful cosmos and our place in it.
So I build telescopes to study light throughout the universe, throughout the history of the universe. And it's a wonderful field, you know, I love what we do, but we're always making these measurements of light that we can't see directly with our eyes. And so it's in many ways a very abstract field. And I love seeing the images that we produce, but again, I've never been able to see something like that. That really gave me a new sense of wonder about the universe. And seeing the eclipse for the first time in 2017 was just amazing for me. It really gave me a kind of renewed sense of wonder about the field of research that we're involved in and being able to experience this more viscerally and directly with my own eyes.